Yo, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlogs. And as always, I appreciate all the love and support. In today's video, Barrett Jackson, Camaro ZLS, Future Collector Car Show. Let's go. All right, right off the bat, you can see we got Superman here today, and we're inside the Toyo booth, so we're kind of early right now before the event actually opens and the doors open.
They're over here drifting too, so Dodge got their Hellcats out and all that good stuff way over there. Everybody's drifting, but at the same time, I don't know, man, what do you guys think?
I think it's time to put some R888s on the ZL1. Shout out to these guys. We are in the talks. There is a quote-unquote sponsorship that has been accepted, so it's just a matter of, do we put the R888s on here or keep these PS4s? What do you guys think? I don't know, let me know. Matt, what do you think? Do we keep the PS4s on there or do we do the R888s right over there?
Those look better.
Let's take a look. All right, so these are going to be the R888s right here, you guys. This is the tire that we were talking about going with. And this actually is my, front tire right here, Matt. This is a 305-3019, you know what I mean? That's the actual tire that we can, I don't know, maybe I should holler at my man right here. And yeah, take off my front tires and go ahead and throw them on. You guys, check out this Benz right here. This is sick. Oh my God, bro. This color, with the briefcase and everything. Holy cow. Man, shout out to the Mopar fam. They're making a lot of noise over there. Bro, this is nasty. What do you guys think? With the, these are Gullwing doors. These are not Lambo doors. These are Gullwing doors. Bro, no way. What's happening right now? What? Okay, I'm confused right now, bro. Was this a Tesla and then they, or what happened?
Yeah, look at the screen.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It matches the color.
You guys, comment down below. Did this car start out as a Tesla or what is this? Like, I don't understand. This is a Mercedes body on the car, but it's a Tesla interior. All right, hold on. That license plate says EV. I don't know. The actual monitor on here has a picture of a Tesla, whatever this is. I like it. And of course, we got my friend Kayla Rundle. Chop, 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 chop. Woo! Good old 15 scale, baby. Fully built. Now this, yes, this is nice. Oh man, that is clean, clean, boy. It blows my mind, Matt. How can you sell this? I wouldn't want to sell this, bro. Look at this. Man, C8 Z06. Okay, that's crazy right there. What the heck is that? There's no roof. What do you think this one is, Matt? Is this an E-Ray? But the placement. It's clean. This is a cool little touch right here. This is old school, where the bottom's still black and then he painted the top. I see what you're doing, Chevy.
I see what you're doing, Chevy. You're watching. I've been had that when I had that satin pearl white, bro. The bottom half was black. I see what you're doing. They need to cut the check, bro.
All right, you guys. Look what I found. Inside, brand new Camaro ZL1 Panther edition. Oh my God, bro, this paint, this is paint, you guys. By the way, this is not a wrap. This is paint right here from factory. Now, I do have a request for the gentleman that brought this car in. Please, come on, don't do me like that. Don't do me like that, wipe the car down, you know what I'm saying? Bro, this is for sale? Are you serious? Man, this, what do you guys think? Should I go satin black? Should I go back
to satin black? That's the question. That is the ultimate question. Do I go back to satin black? Now, I used to have satin black before. Okay, hold on. Before you guys answer that, satin black with my calipers painted red, that is a crazy combo. Now, this being the Panther edition, I do like how they have the Camaro put on the side right there. I do like that. I do like that. Mine is a little bit lower where it has Superman ZL1. Inside is pretty basic. Other than the steering wheel, it does have the badge on it. But then the little sticker that they put right here, it sets it apart. Right there. That's pretty cool how they did that. Oh, it's all a one piece. Okay, okay. It's a one piece vinyl right here. And then right here in the center, it's cut out. Okay. All right. Nice little idea, you know what I'm saying? I like that. Matt, we definitely need one of these right here, bro. Do you think people are gonna look at us in a certain way where they're gonna be like, I don't know, bro, these guys are like overkill at this point, like, but I don't know, dude, I like that. You guys, leave a comment down below in the chat. Let me know, I like it. Put an HC badge right in the middle, dude. I like it, and it's for sale, too. If you're gonna, oh, this is a GM official product? Are you serious? Okay, that is sick. I need a card or something. This is crazy, dude.
These pillars are just filled with air. Comes with an air compressor, fan, and filter.
Okay.
Fan runs 24/7.
Oh, yeah, you can feel that.
The air that circulates escapes through the zippers.
Okay.
We replace the air about 5 times an hour. The reason that's important is because you never get air. Air is never stagnant.
Okay.
So as long as this keeps moving, you never hit a dew point, you'll never get moisture. The fan makes enough noise, keeps rodents away. No dust or dirt, we have a filter on the back of it.
So the filter, every when is it required to change?
It depends on the environment.
Okay.
Like the one I have at home, I've never replaced it.
I've
had it 4 years. I've cleaned it a few times, vacuumed it.
That's
about it. The pump that maintains the pillars, there's a check valve.
Okay.
When the pillar loses about a quarter PSI, it'll kick on by itself, bring it back to pressure, and shut off. But the fan runs 24/7. Then it has doors, drive in and out, has door on either side so you can get inside and play with the vehicle when it's in storage. These are indoor models, we make outdoor ones as well.
Yeah. See that? That's why I wanted to make sure I got it on camera, because there's other things possible, indoor, outdoor. I didn't know that before we started vlogging.
We custom make them for RVs, for cars, for trailers, for boats.
Oh yeah. No, this is good stuff. And the cars are for sale too?
We don't sell them, but House of Cars, we're getting.
Oh, okay. Because they got the for sale signs.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, man. Thank
All
you.
Right, thanks.
What do you guys think of this Bugatti? What do you think of this Bugatti right here, bro? What color is your Bugatti? I don't know. Mine is red, black. It's a little bit of a mix.
What color is your Bugatti?
My man. What do you guys think? Too much? Too little? I like it. It was good to me. It's a trip though. Like, it's like a tribal type of a finish. It looks really, really good. But would you guys buy one if you bought a Bugatti? Would you buy one that had all this going on? Or would you buy a solid color one? Because all this going on kind of reminds me of a video game. But I do like driving around the cars in Forza. Shout out to this lady, you know what I'm saying? She's gonna cut the check, yeah? All right, Matt. So I think me and you had spoken about it, but this is my dad's section here, and I believe your dad?
Yeah.
Oh my God, they both like Mustangs, and me and Matt both drive a ZL1.
So go figure, bro. Like, but this is sick.
Definitely gotta get them to meet.
Oh yeah.
They haven't met yet, but we'll get them to meet. But this is crazy. Can you imagine just a simple oil change, dude? Like, look at this guy right here. All you gotta do is bring it down some and you're changing oil. You're not laying on the ground where, like, you gotta stretch your arms back and all this stuff. And then if you wanna upgrade the suspension and start changing the toe links and control arms and all this stuff, it's right there, bro. And I like how they got this light right here, this LED strip.
I've never seen this before. This guy's car is literally hitting switches. Who's controlling that?
That is crazy.
Oh, it's cheaper from us.
That's sick. Wow. And of course, Iron Man 3. So out of all these toys, Lord of Fire, look what Max spotted.
Boom! Brenton!
I do have that though, I think. I think Paramount Pictures sent me that.
Shout out to Paramount Pictures on that giveaway that we did for Rise of the Beast. But we did a collab together and partnered with Paramount Pictures for that.
And they sent me a bunch of goodies.
And I think one of them was that. It's all packaged up.
So, that's crazy.
Oh, so we got Optimus. And then you got Nemesis Prime. Sick.
So I thought this was a Mustang garage because it has Shelby on the side. And then we turn the corner and of course, boom. ZL1, 1LE baby, tucked in here. Matt, is this a sign, bro? We were just talking about this kind of floor finish. And then all of a sudden, there's a ZL1. Okay, okay. Okay, that looks like Spider-Man, bro. That's sick. Right? Okay, okay. All right. So is this the big boy section? Is that what this section is? I think it's the big boy section. A lot of the exotics are here with this current setup. I like it. And then on this side, I thought I saw it somewhere over there. I did, Matt, right there. A whole parachute on that Demon. That's a Dodge Demon for sure. You can tell by the setup on the wheels. Another one, sick. Whoa. Video literally does no justice. I'm telling you, can you see the wing in the back, bro? Do you see the wing in the back? Holy cow. Oh, this is a straight track car. All right, full carbon fiber Bugatti Chiron with a mix of blue carbon and solid standard black carbon fiber.
All right, you guys, so this is where
millions of dollars are spent here, because what they'll do is they'll bring up the car up front and people will start bidding. There's going to be more people as we go. And then up here, this is the skybox up top.
It was great.
Right there.
It was
great. This is what you'll see on television.
Moving the Future Collector Car Show. This is part of the future of the collector car hobby.
All right. You know when you walk in through certain doors and they say, welcome to heaven? So we're walking into the... We're starting out right off the bat in the Chevy section, which is the best section. And we're going to start right over here to the left. Boom. What a LT4. Let's take a look here. Let's work our way around. Old school with a new school motor. Look at that, Matt. That looks good. Here's another spec. Pose for the camera, my boy. For that camera. This is the E-Ray, right? I think this one is the E-Ray. Yes, this one is the E-Ray. A nice spec inside. We got a new owner. I just sold him the car. This one here looks sick, but this one here, look at this spec. Oh my god, dude. This, bro, look at the seats and everything. This spec right here is absolutely gorgeous. Oh my god, this is my favorite Z06 so far with the specs. This is gonna be it. I really like the black and red, bro. That's just menacing, bro. That dude over there just rubbing all over the carbon fiber wing. Look at him, massaging the wing, like, and he's using it to help him go around. God damn. Come on, man. Look at this.
Okay, let's let somebody else get a turn, okay?
Oh, yeah. This is sick, bro. That's all Alcantara back there. And he's still holding on to the wing, my man. Do what you gotta do, brother. Yeah. What do you guys think? Leave a comment on this one. Okay, bro. Things
just got very, very serious at the moment. Now.
Good morning.
Now we're talking.
1,500 horsepower.
I don't think I can handle it.
Yanko. Camaro ZL1.
Now we're talking.
Oh, no.
1,500 horsepower Camaro SS. Bro.
Let's go look at the Yanko escalators.
This is no joke, bro. With the Whipple inside. Okay, you guys, I got a question. So many people said to me, go with the Magnuson 2650 and don't go with the Whipple. Why is the Whipple in all the high horsepower Camaros? If that's the case.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Is this one has more horsepower than the Hennessy?
This one does have more horsepower than the Hennessy. Hey, Matt, we need one of these. We need one of these.
Oh, yeah.
I need this. What the hell? What is this? It's called Karma. Bro, imagine you're driving around and then you just see this drive past you. And you're like, what's going on here? Like, you have no idea what's happening. This is absolutely nuts. Because I'm imagining the tail light is just a strip, just like it shows there. That's what I'm imagining. I think you got a slide to open the door. You slide all the way.
Is it working?
No, it's not gonna. Everybody be sitting in the car. But see, there's a bunch of fingerprints. Everybody tried it. All right. I saw this on TikTok the other day. It is a chopped Hummer. Bang. Look at the back, bro. Wow. This spec. Oh my God, bro. I don't even want to show you that back wheel. Hold on. Bro, this is insane. I don't know how many times I'm gonna say this, I'm sorry, but this is crazy. We're literally just talking about looking at a black old school. Okay, so you got the front wheel, look at the back wheel. Take this, I'll do it with the other one. Oh yeah, 100%. Yeah, that's sick. Fifth gen Cobo Camaro. Beautiful setup. All right, there we go. This is the big boy right here. This is the big boy right here. You don't want no smoke with this, bro. There's another one right next to it. There's another one literally right next to it. Matt, look at this. See the inside of the motor. Damn, that is insane, bro. Oh yeah, they're loud, bro. Two absolute beasts side by side, bro. Anybody in here, whoever wanted, they could get it. All right, you guys, so the Dodge section, this section here, what it's doing is it's giving people a ride with them in the car, and they're drifting around kind of like that. Even though that was a Toyota Supra, because you got Ford,
Toyota,
and you got Dodge. Yes, this Z28. Whew. Just oh, and right behind it. Oh my God! Somebody's gonna buy these cars.
All right, you guys. So I think me and Matt are gonna go ahead and wrap up this vlog right here. We pretty much took a walk through just about almost the entire show. Yeah. The only section we didn't go to was in the grass where everybody's doing the car show area. But for the most part, we did get Future Collectors car show, you know, in the beginning phase of the video. So I appreciate them inviting me out and having us out here. But either way, hopefully you guys enjoyed today's content. And if it's your first time on the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. A thumbs up definitely helps out the channel. Leave me a comment, let me know what you guys think. There was definitely a lot of nice cars here. But in the meantime, between time, you guys know the drill. Hey, Dilla, bow, Superman, chilling out there in front of the Toyo booth. Prime time, chilling in the garage. His ZL1, chilling out there as well. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.
Fast life, the fast living. They see the ambition, they know I'm past driven. Look, we are not the same, this is not a game. I've been swerving through the city.